So here we are, guys. Tom Owens here with the MMA Fight Pass, Hammer Fist Podcast. And we're doing our first segment of Inside the Dojo. We're here at Elite Team Visalia, California. And we're going to go inside. We're going to give you a grand tour. You're going to see some kids training. You're going to see me get choked out and arm locked by little 13-year-olds and younger. And it's going to be great, man. Come on in. So we're here. We're going in. Jiu-Jitsu in the Valley is growing like no other, guys, and this is one of the best spots, and we're going to check it out. We're going to dive in. We're going to see what's going on in here. It's going to be great. Visalia Cryo here. Got the Planning Mill Pizza if you want to get a little pizza after. Let's come on through this cryotherapy. This is a little therapy room. You get hurt, injured, you train hard, you're getting ready for a competition. You need to get that cryotherapy. Cryotherapy is the next best thing when you're wanting to get healed up quick for another. You need, say you need to train again tomorrow hard, but you're sore. This is the spot right here. Come on in, guys. Come on in.
How's it going, guys?
Hey, sir.
I'm Tom Owens. I'm with the MMA Fight Pass. Mm-hmm. Is this you filming?
Oh, cool, man.
Yeah, how about you tell us a little bit about the cryotherapy?
Yeah, so body cryotherapy, it's like a, basically a more technologically advanced way to recover nowadays.
Yeah.
It's along the same lines as an ice bath.
Yeah.
3 minutes in this machine is equal to an hour, 20-minute ice bath.
3 minutes in the machine?
Yeah.
Can we see it?
Yeah, sure.
Wow.
You step in here, door closes. You can get in there if you want.
Yeah. So say I'm all sore, been training all week, I'm feeling kind of crippled, like from the other day, these guys got me. So you just come in this bad boy?
Yeah, you can step in there with shoes on. Bam. And then I'll close the door. I'll sit in there for 3 minutes. And then once
again, how sore does this thing get?
Dude, it gets down to -300.
So what does that do? What's the great benefit for the body?
So what it does is it stresses your cold stresses your body, obviously, right? So what we're doing is we're reaching those temperatures specifically to reduce your skin temperature. And that rapid drop inside that 3 minutes is enough to create norepinephrine in the brain. It's a stress hormone.
Yeah.
And then what that does is create a ton of anti-inflammatories, doubles your collagen production, and gives you a nice endorphin rush afterwards, so you feel nice and relaxed.
Yeah. So are a lot of people taking advantage of it?
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Yes. All right. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, no
appreciate
problem.
It. All right, let's go into the dojo.
Nice. Good stuff.
This facility is top notch, guys. I've been to all the gyms in the area, and a lot of gyms around California. And I'm super, super excited to have this here in Visalia, California. It's so cool. What do we got here?
This is actually just an office.
All right.
We're sneaking through on this side.
I got your text, man.
So this is the gym right here. This is the advanced kids class going on right now. We're gonna get a little look at some training. We're gonna check out some technique. And then at some point I'll get on the mat and get strangled.
All right, let's do this way.
What's that?
You guys train right?
No. We're here. You're gonna choke me. And punch me in the face maybe.
All right.
Just for kids. All right, so what do we got here?
So this is also the other, this is what originally started like the cryo place. So like myself and John Wheeler, we opened the gym side.
But John Wheeler is part of this deal too?
Yeah.
Myself
and John were the...
Is that Wheeler the kickboxer?
His son was.
His
son was, yeah.
All right. Hey, there you go. So now, we're going in here, guys. We've got Doug the Rhino Marshall. This is a, what exactly got going on?
So this is a strength and conditioning room. The strength and conditioning for like the extra stuff. People who compete, the MMA fighters, they don't get our specialized training one-on-one. You get your conditioning for competition. So people take this stuff real serious.
Yeah.
Obviously, you can see these guys are training here every day. So
these guys getting ready for a fight or something?
These guys really just like to train.
Yeah.
So they go to regular class and then they get privates from Doug one-on-one.
Yeah.
So you get real focus on the individual in this place.
Yeah. So we got Doug the Rhino Marshall. Let's go and get Doug over here, guys.
What's up, baby? How you doing? What do you got going on here?
Right. We're here with this podcast,
the Hammer Fist Podcast. So
everybody, you guys know, Doug the Rhino Marshall right here. Hey, I told you the training at this place is legit. It's top notch. You want to get some good Muay Thai? The real Muay Thai. I'm not talking just YouTube Muay Thai. It's some guy acting like he knows what he's doing. This guy knows what he's doing.
Come see us, man.
Know this guy forever. Tell us a little bit about this, bro.
This is our strength and conditioning spot. This is, we call it, I call it the pro side. We got guys training for fights, come up with comers coming up. This is where I do all my privates. This is obviously where we get our strength and conditioning on. This is where... Absolutely, yes.
What about a guy that just wants to come and get a shape?
Oh yeah, we do want to
work out with you too?
Absolutely, what we do, this is where I do all my private lessons, my personal training and stuff.
Rest, guys, that's good for today.
This is actually where I'm doing my strength conditioning for my up and coming fight.
What is that fucking happening?
Can I tell you?
Okay, all right.
Hey, it's a secret, but
are you going to be training in here tonight? You going to come back in here a little bit? Maybe get a couple clips?
My next time I'll be in here training will be the fall morning.
Okay.
Tonight I actually have jiu-jitsu.
Okay, good round here. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just going to do a few rounds, get myself
maybe
back.
Can you get a moment on the bag, throw a couple techniques maybe?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Maybe punch me in the face or something?
We can do that. I mean, you know, long as you don't triangle me.
Can you show me how to throw a dolly into a busting belt?
Oh, no, I leave that for the Irish. I only throw these and these.
Oh, these.
Yeah.
All right, my brother.
It was good seeing you. I'll see you tonight.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Let's go this way. Let's meet this guy over here. Another guy that has a program here. His name is Eric Fees, guys. Let's come over here.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Here with the podcast, Fight Class.
Oh, right on.
And this is Eric Fees. Tell us a little bit about your program here.
What I do mainly is I do personal training here. I'm a black belt next door also, but I do personal training here. And my clientele base is particularly obese people and those with disabilities.
Okay.
I'm not really interested in the athletes or anything like that. Like, yeah. We've got all those covered.
Uh-huh.
Mine is doing the need to change. You know, I want to make a little bit of a difference.
Life's so longer now.
It is, you know, and they're only getting bigger. So that's my
goal. A lot of them want.
Oh, good. Yeah, it's almost sad, but we're doing good work.
So how many days and nights a week are you out here?
I'm here 5 days a week right now. I start at 5, and, you know, we work on and off throughout the day. I start at 5, and usually end at 8 or 9.
All right.
Awesome. We're doing good things.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. We'll see you on the mat.
All right.
Now, let's go. Let's get a little look on the mat, guys. Guide me in the right direction. All right, here we go, guys. All right, guys. So check it out. We got a class going on right now.
You're good.
Got a class going on right now. When we get a chance here, we'll talk to some instructors. And I'll even get out there on the mat and we'll have these guys choke me out. How you doing, sir?
Pretty good.
Ah! They should all be right around here.
Hey, brother.
Hello? Okay, right now we're going to go back and forth with the guard poles. Okay? Let's say set the position and then say that you guys should have at least 2 or 3 guards that you'd like to have across the side over to. At least 2 for sure. 3 better. Right here, if you have a problem with you and you make contact with your head, make a contact with the
Looks like it's still on.
This is my nephew. Shake his hand and introduce yourself. Yeah. Hey, he's gonna be one of your teachers. He's gonna be starting tomorrow. Let's see if we can get that right around the floor.
I think I remember you.
Hey, Tyler. Hey, here.
Jacob Cisneros.
Thank you.
what's going on here. This gym is just tremendous. It's awesome. Best jiu-jitsu school in the area by far. This is Tom Knox, old friend of mine. Grew up with this guy skateboarding, following this guy around on a skateboard. Always a legit individual. He was always somebody that we looked up to. And grew up free, alcohol-free, just the right attitude. And was always out to get to the next level in skateboarding. Later on, as my life progressed and I got into jiu-jitsu, and I came back from college, turns out Tom Knox had been training judo and jiu-jitsu as well. And so we kind of trained together for a while back in the day. And now, this is his school. This is your place.
Man, I
this is an awesome place, bro. Tell us a little bit about it.
Started the gym in 2008. Moved back to Orange County. And just started small. My plan was to grow if I did, but it was just always the focus of training jiu-jitsu and creating world-class jiu-jitsu players.
You were in Orange County, but you were training with Clever Luciano, right?
Yeah, I still train with Clever, but yeah, that's
Clever. Talk a little bit about that.
We're a Clever Luciano affiliate, but when I moved to Orange County, I looked at several gyms, but at that time, Clever had the top team that he wasn't even the closest gym to my house, but it was the one I wanted to go to and train at.
So what stood out with Clever that made you? Because I know we were going around the gym.
He just had a very attacking style. I had seen him in some tournaments. Finishing style. And a very aggressive style. And I saw his team always doing well. And I'm like, man, I want to go there. So I went and tried out a class. And the first class, I just got delivered. And I'm like, all right, this is what I need. This is what I need to be. I went in there with a belt. And, the guys just destroyed me.
How often do you train Clever?
Now I have a gym. I try to make it there once or twice a month. Yeah. Or he comes up here. What started as a student teacher relationship, that's one of my best friends.
Yeah.
We travel all around the world together doing seminars.
He's in the cage.
He just fought 2 weeks ago. In Korea, in the cage. That was one of my best friends. I'm with his family, we go holidays together. He just gave me a lot of guidance on how to open the gym and run the gym. And just have a successful academy. So I just took all of his blueprint that he laid out a long time ago.
Been doing well. I've always followed in the world of jiu-jitsu. Man, you competition. Break it down a little bit. You're ranked number one.
For Master 4. Winning certain tournaments. Bigger tournaments are worth more points. Smaller tournaments are worth less points. I won Europeans, Nationals, Pan Ams. Next week is Master World Championships, the biggest
Vegas?
One. Yeah, Vegas.
That's the big one.
And then 2 weeks after that, I'll be back in Japan.
Wow.
So, it's been
quite a journey.
It's been a journey, but last year I went to Brazil and won the South American Championships, so it just keeps going.
That's awesome, man.
I just love the traveling.
Love to travel. You still skateboard too?
All the time. I take my skateboard everywhere. I take it to Japan, take it to Brazil.
Wow.
Man, half my friends in Brazil train and skate.
Oh, really?
Moving the brake, guys! It's fun, man.
Yeah. I'm so proud of your school here, bro. It's just really, really cool, man. I'm here and I'm going to be coming. My friends are going to be coming down and shooting stuff, man. So, spread that guy's the whole thing.
Who are you rolling sometime?
I got the younger one.
Yeah, Jacob. You sure you went down there?
Hey, John. Hey, come over here.
Okay.
I'm warning you. It's not going to be fun.
I know. It hasn't been fun at all.
I'm warning you.
These brothers, the Cisneros brothers, if you follow the jiu-jitsu world and you follow competition, they are tearing it up. I just hear nothing but good stuff, man.
Josh Cisneros.
How old are you? 14. How long have you been training? 6 years.
6 years
now.
Go, guys!
Getting ready to fight again, I heard.
Everything goes right.
Good luck.
Go ahead, it's last round.
Thank you, Tom.
Yeah, have fun.
Thank you.
since the first month that it opened, so over 10 years. Yeah. I got my start training with some white belts at the Black Belt Center, Mark and Katie Posada. Okay. Trained with them for about 7 months, and then I met Tom when he was a purple belt, had a neon belly like I couldn't believe, and when I heard he opened up a gym, I wanted to train with him. So I've been here since.
Did you get your kids going right away?
We didn't have a kids program here at first. I came to Tom, I said, Tom, I need to start a kids program. I got a 5-year-old son, I want to learn jiu-jitsu. Tom said, hey, if you want to start a kids program, go ahead and do it. And fast forward 9 years later, we produced world champions, national champions, and probably got the biggest kids league around.
Really tremendous. What do you attribute that to? You guys are stacking
up. For adults or kids or both?
Because I know I got a lot of people out there with kids, and you know, there's multiple schools that they can go and train at. And I always tell them, you know, go around, you gotta try different places out. But this place really stands out for me. And when people research online,
I think it has to do with the consistency of the training. We bring them here and we tell them, look, this is going to be like an adult class. We're not going to play dodgeball every class. It's not going to be just babysitting. So they're doing the exact same drills the adults are doing. They roll every class as well. We put them in a lot of competition scenarios where, okay, you're down 2 points, what do you do here? You're up, how can you maintain the position? And we shape everything around that competition environment, prepping them for it. And we hold them accountable to it too. You know, if they're not going to push themselves, you know, if you're going to out of class, if you're not going to behave, you're going to sit out, and they usually rise to the occasion. You know, we push them and hold them to a higher standard. They have never let us down yet.
Awesome. Man, I just thank you for that. Coming here, you know, bro, and I'll be back.
Thank you. Yeah, keep training with us.
Yeah, we're going to keep training. All right, so Tom Owens here. You guys just saw me just get wrapped up in 50,000 different ways by these kids here. I had the honor to meet these kids at a very young age and work just real briefly with them. And man, I've followed you guys, I've watched you guys since you know, Tom Hobbs, these guys, and man, I'm super impressed. What do you attribute to the greatest transformation? By the way, this is David Cisneros, their father. Okay? Can you guys say your name close enough?
I'm Josh.
Josh? Caleb?
I'm Jacob.
And that's the mom right there, Heather Austin, the visual. Yeah, so hey, what do you got? Break it down for us.
Persistence.
How many days a week do you guys train?
3 to 4 days a week. And two of that time to twice a week. Sometimes 3 times a day. And I'm only
that close to the moment. My nephew's brand new, and I'm going to be bringing my sister to the nephew to work with him. Are you guys working with him?
Yeah. I will see a master's test.
Yeah. Okay. So I might get him going, maybe get with him a little bit. What's a good thing to come from the games?
Monday, Wednesday, then.
Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday?
And then on Saturday, we've got kids out here.
Now, you guys got competition coming up?
Yeah.
Everybody?
Next time.
Vegas. So he's competing in Vegas next week. What about the test?
These two will compete against the favorites on the other side.
Right on, guys. We'll be back again, man. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much for the roles. Thank you for not hurting me. That was awesome. I'm so impressed with you guys, man. Hey, thank you so much, brother. I appreciate it, man. You guys have a good night. There we go.